In this video, I'll be talking about the terrestrial biosphere. Now we will start with some definitions. Terrestrial can be defined as land, while the terrestrial biosphere is that land that is occupied by organisms, such as plants and animals. Now the climate regulates the condition and the distribution of the terrestrial biosphere. While the climate can be influenced by the latitude, the altitude, and the land-sea configuration. Now we can classify the climate into five main categories using the Koppen climate classification system. The categories are tropical, capital A, dry, capital B, temperate, C, continental, D, and polar, E. The vegetation type of the terrestrial biosphere is determined by the amount of rain it receives and the temperature, while the annual temperature and precipitation are controlled by solar radiation. This map shows the Koppen climate classification system, where we see the five main categories again: A for tropical, B for dry, C for temperate, D for continental, and E for polar. In the north and south poles, they are categorized as polar, and at the equator, we see more areas that are categorized as tropical, and somewhere above the equator or below the equator, the regions become more temperate or dry. This distribution shows the effects of latitude on the climate of an area, where it is directly related to solar radiation, which in turn affects temperature and precipitation in that area. Now, aside from climate classification, there's also the biome classification, which looks almost similar to the climate classification, except for now it's for the organisms or living things. Now, the biomes are created by the climate, or the climate influences the type of biomes that exist in an area. Now, what are biomes? Biomes are communities of plants and animals and other living things that thrive in an environment. Now, the biome can be categorized just like the Koppen climate classification system into many groups, and this is mainly based on the temperature and precipitation, again, just like the climate classification. There are many classification systems, but the most popular ones are the Whitaker classification and the Walter classification. Now, the main biomes are the tundra, the tropical rainforest, savanna, etc. Now, in the right, you see a figure that shows the effect of annual average temperature and annual precipitation on the types of biomes that can be produced in an area. For example, for the tropical rainforest, you see the temperature range is between 25 to 30 degrees with a very high annual precipitation range as compared to the other types of biomes. While for the boreal forest, the temperature range is less than 10 degrees Celsius with a less amount of annual precipitation. In other words, precipitation and temperature would affect the type of biomes that can thrive in that area. Now, this is another map that shows the distribution of surfaces on Earth, but instead of the climate categorization, it is the biomes categorization. The patches looks almost similar to the climate classification because of the direct relationship between biomes and climate. But instead of the tropical, the temperate, continental, and polar, and etc. classification, we see here the evergreen needleleaf forest, or the woody savanna, or the grassland, which shows that the classification done here is for the main vegetation type of the surface. Now, this map has been produced by using satellite imagery as well as ground-based observations. This map shows another classification of biomes, and it's different from the previous map because it categorizes surface using different names, such as the montane forest, or the alpine tundra, or the taiga, the subtropical rainforest, the Mediterranean vegetation, the monsoon forest, and etc. But the patches or the distribution of biomes are similar as with the other classification systems. In summary, we see that the climate affects the biome by providing a set of temperature and precipitation that favors a biome. But the biome also has an effect on the climate through processes that occur in the biome. For example, by the plants, which undergoes photosynthesis or evapotranspiration. And these processes affects the water or the hydrologic cycle. Now, another example is for surfaces that are covered by snow. And because of the color white of the snow, it reflects the incoming solar radiation to space, which lowers the overall energy absorbed by the surface. And this too can affect the climate.